A very good morning to all of you, my dear children. So today in biology class, we will revise chapter number 7, conservation of plants and animals. We will have a quick revision of the chapter. So starting with the first topic, that is deforestation. As we have already studied, deforestation is the process of cutting the forest, clearing the forest for human needs to fulfill human demands. Okay, so this is called deforestation. So what are the consequences of deforestation? There are various consequences like global warming, the increase in the temperature of earth, there is increased chances of floods, droughts and other natural calamities. There is a consequence of deforestation, that is pollution of air. Okay, and if forest is cleared, the animal living there will lose their natural habitat, which will lead to their extinction, or they will become endangered species. So loss of habitat. Okay, so these were some consequences of deforestation. Now what is biodiversity? As we have already learned, biodiversity is the different forms of life found on the earth, like plants, animals, microorganisms and all the other living creatures found in an area or on the earth is called biodiversity. Okay, now when deforestation is there, the animals will lose their natural habitat where they live. So deforestation leads to the destruction of the natural habitat of the animals. So the animals will lose their natural habitat. So animals will go roam to other places and their number will be decreased because they may be killed by other animals or some human beings. So their number will decrease. So the species whose number keeps on decreasing to the verge that they might get extinct, they might get completely vanished from the earth. So those species are called endangered species. The species whose numbers are decreasing, that they are at the verge of extinction, are called endangered species. Their reason might be loss of habitat or excessive killing or hunting them. So the species whose number are decreasing that much that they are at the verge of extinction, means they might get extinct, the species might completely get vanished from the earth. So those species are called endangered species. Okay, so to protect the wildlife, to protect the trees and other life forms of the forest, to protect the nature, the government have constructed various protected areas in which those animals, plants and other species are conserved from hunting, poaching, okay, or killing. So the protected areas are, the first one is a biosphere reserve, as we have studied in the chapter. It is a large protected area for the conservation of the biodiversity, like all the type of life forms, all different types of life forms are protected in that particular forest, whether they are plants, animals, microorganisms or any other living species. So this is the biosphere reserve. Another one is wildlife sanctuary. Wildlife sanctuaries are the protected areas in which the animals of that particular area are protected from hunting, killing, poaching. Okay, so in wildlife area there is a focus on the wild animals living in that particular area. Okay, so these were, another one is national parks also conserve the forest. It is a large protected area in which the animals and the plants of that particular area are protected in their natural habitat. Basically, they also focus on the animals. So, national parks are the large protected areas where animals are conserved in their natural habitat. Okay, so these were some protected areas for the protection of biodiversity, wildlife, and other life forms. So, these are the protected areas. Now, there are flora and fauna. As we have already learned while doing the chapter, flora are the plant species found in a particular area naturally, which are found only in a particular area naturally, are called flora of that area. Fauna are the animal species found in a particular area. Flora are the plants found in a particular area. Fauna are the animals found in a particular area. So, these are flora and fauna. Now, how can we protect the wildlife? How can we save the nature? So, the very simple way by which we can save the nature is by reforestation. Reforestation is the process of restocking of the forest. Means by growing more and more trees, by conserving the forest, by growing the forest again. Like planting more and more trees, reforestation can take place on its own by leaving the land undisturbed for years, so that the plants grow by themselves by natural processes. Okay, so we can save the environment. We can save the environment from all the problems by simply growing more and more trees, so that there is a healthy environment for plants, animals, and even for us, for human beings.